There's not too much written about Teresa Graves. She was known for being a singer, an actress, and a model, and a comedian, having appeared on TV in the TV series Laugh-In. And she famously quit Hollywood to become a Jehovah's Witness. Teresa was influenced by her Jehovah's Witness cousin Peggy to become a witness herself. While Teresa was in England in 1973, filming Old Dracula, which was released in 74, right before Armageddon, folks. What timing! Jehovah had his hand in this. Teresa became intensely involved in the religion, acting in the film by day and studying the Bible by night. Her timing was right for the Watchtower Society to exploit her fame. She was young and beautiful, and she was a perfect example for the teens of the day to quit life and work for Jehovah instead. Her platform was a Malawi issue and the persecution of Jehovah's Witnesses, and bringing international awareness to their persecution in Malawi under the leader of the Hastings Kamuzu Banda's one-party rule. For the rest of her life, she was a JW. Her neighbors didn't know who she was, that she used to be a famous actress and singer. They only knew her as Tootie, as she was called. She died in a house fire in 2002 in her home in LA that she shared with her mother, who's in the hospital at the time, having suffered a stroke, so she was not in the house at the time. Teresa's a good example of how the Watchtower Society uses celebrity to push their name to the forefront in the news and national arena. At the time, early 70s, the JWs did a massive letter-writing campaign to the government of Malawi, where the brothers were brutally tortured and killed. Many fled to nearby Zambia. So instead of complying with their government, many JWs were brutally murdered just because the governing body's God Jehovah wanted a massive blood ritual sacrifice of those brothers and sisters. Interesting that I never heard of one of the governing body members dying via torture and murder for their religious beliefs. It won't happen, but the sheep can be slaughtered. Ray Franz talks about the Malawi incident in his book. He talks about the policies of the governing body and crisis of conscience. The policy regarding the political cards and military service in Malawi and its inconsistency with the way things were handled in Mexico. Brothers in Mexico could bribe officials while the brothers in Malawi could not, and they couldn't escape. If they couldn't escape, they were murdered for not complying with the government. The Watchtower used Teresa Graves' fame to be their spokesperson to push forward with this basic publicity stunt for the Watchtower. The Watchtower mandates its membership blatantly disobey governmental authorities and then cries victim when they're attacked, harassed, and banned for their actions. It shows you what the society will do. They use famous people when they can. They go on TV shows, they say the name of Jehovah on those national talk shows or events at concerts or at a sports event thanking Jehovah for them winning the top prize. This is the JW organization. They use whoever they can while the Watchtower plays victim time and time again when they are not victims. They are cunning manipulators, and all they want is national attention. Publicity for playing victim. Then eventually they want cash donations for portraying themselves as victims of Big Brother when they grift off of Big Brother. They take handouts, getting tax-free status, tell members to get help from social programs while they pocket billions to buy more real estate. Playing victim is what they're good at while they're snatching your wallets when you turn your back. Teresa Graves died without Armageddon coming, without seeing that new system in her lifetime, because it's fake. It's a con job. Jehovah's Witnesses do not own this world. They do not own the Bible. They do not own God. They cannot and never will be able to grant you life. Stop falling down this path of delusion with the JWs. The governing body do not have the power of life and death. This is the life we were all given now. Do not waste it on devotion to a religion with failed promises. They are grifters and con artists. Stop supporting them with your time, labor, and money. See what happens. Let the governing body pray to their God Jehovah for money. Oh, gee, sorry. The flock has woken up. They won't be slaughtered at your feet anymore. Unknowingly, this is the narcissism the Watchtower sells you. Teresa was relating her experience of becoming a Jehovah Witness at a convention. She says there are over 4 billion people in the world, and Jehovah chose us. No, Teresa, we were victims of masters of a con game. This is what the Jehovah's Witnesses are taught to believe. Oh, we were chosen by God, not our neighbor, not the person who may devote their lives to charity work. Maybe they're just a good person. Maybe they volunteer at food banks. Maybe they're great providers for their family. Maybe a single mom has to work 3 jobs to support her kids. So these people were not chosen by Jehovah. No, they're all from a worldly church or no church at all. This is a narcissism that the Watchtower teaches. Teresa Grace fell into it without knowing it. It is sickening the way JWs feed off of celebrity and use it until there is nothing left. The governing body exploits famous people whenever they can. Oh, gee, you need to do your preaching work on that TV show or at that concert. Make sure to shout out Jehovah's name. That can be your service to God. Jehovah's Witnesses cannot face their future. They will die as mere mortals in the world like all of us. You are not special, Jehovah's Witnesses. Drop the narcissism. You are no better than the next guy who's trying their best to make it in this world. How dare you think a good person will not make it into Jehovah's paradise? Paradise, I think scriptures say, is in heaven and not earthly. JWs love saying that Jehovah chose you to be in his organization. You were selected out of the world, catering to your ego. When it was not Jehovah that plucked you out of the world, it was Jehovah's Witnesses who saw a vulnerable person, an easy mark. They will destroy your life if you let them. They will take your time, labor, and money if you let them. Teresa relates her entire story in an audio file. The link to her full experience is in the description box below my video here. But she connects the dots only like a newly indoctrinated person can. She was talking with her cousin Peggy, who's a JW, basically doing a lot of her own reading and studying out of Watchtower material. Then Teresa had to fly to England to shoot a movie about Dracula. She was his bride. It just was a campy comedy horror film. Oh, geez, she says in that experience that she was giving, where she tells how she came into the organization, she says, her cousin Peggy said, Satan will attack you. People will try and stop you from studying with the JWs. So she connects the dots. It was Satan who not only sent her out of the country to England to make a movie, but it was about Dracula, no less. You can't get more demonic than that. When she fails to notice the opposite. Teresa had already signed to make the movie Old Dracula. Then a Jehovah's Witness enters her life, her cousin. A clear pathway opens up to study with the JWs, both in LA, and then she connects with a congregation in England while she's filming her movie. JWs will press you to not read the Bible, but only their literature. So Teresa's led down a path. She repeats this rhetoric. Oh, she read the Bible, she couldn't understand it. Cousin Peggy was right, I need the society's literature. It's just bizarre how the JWs always follow this same playbook. Throughout Teresa relating her experience at that convention, how she joined the JWs, she never says that she was told to stick with the Bible. She was told to stick with Watchtower literature. This is because it's designed to indoctrinate you into their belief system. You will be trapped, you'll quit your job, you'll be at the mercy of society. So I'm speculating as to why Teresa needed to completely drop out of show business. She made unreasonable demands on her agent and the producers of her TV show, Get Christy Love, about a female cop. After one season, it was canceled, but she leaves show business. Maybe she was independently wealthy or worked at some other job, but there are plenty of Christians that work in Hollywood. She could work for PBS, a kids show, or national news show like the Today Show. She was a model and singer. She could do that and still be a JW. Commercial modeling work is benign. She could model hair products or toothpaste. It's just strange that she dropped out completely. Well, she says to devote her life to Jehovah. Okay, but why quit working? There's a backstory she's not revealing. Plenty of actors are JWs in Hollywood and New York, and many are Christian, and they have their own standards. They still find plenty of work. There is plenty of children's programming, family programming. Okay, she walked away from the spotlight, and I think she's fighting her own internal demons that we'll never know about. So, I hope she was happy with her decision, and I hope she didn't suffer in her fire, that fire that swept through her home. Rest in peace, Teresa. We don't know what amazing things you would have done had Satan's birds from the Watchtower had not plucked you out of that field, caged you inside the walls of the Watchtower, and never let you go. Like that flame to a matchstick, she died from burns and smoke inhalation. Like a puff of smoke, she was gone.
A lot of people, it's not the same. We are, listen, there are over 4 billion people in this world, and Jehovah chose us.